Alrighty, pretty easy keep on the draw here, since, well, hopefully a 2-drop awaits, but, even if it doesn't, I still have Mardu Horde Chief into Flame Rush Rider, though. Yeah, that's a nice little combo. You play this on turn 3, turn 4 you dash out Flame Rush Rider, and, the token will, in fact, make another token because you will have attacked by then. Playing against... looks like black-white here. No, Esper. Classic combination. I've drafted Esper a few times, so... well, I'm not dissing it. My man is perfect, as predicted. And I'm very glad I have Whirlwind Adept in my deck instead of Alabaster Kieran. I would much rather draw the Whirlwind Adept here. So, opponent's just playing... at least 4 colors. I'm not ruling out the 5th, though. Lotus Path Djinn. Alright, so... if I Flame Rush Rider, what ends up happening? I attack with 2 Horde Chiefs and a Flame Rush Rider. My opponent presumably double blocks Flame Rush Rider with Lotus Path Djinn. Takes 4, and I end up with an extra token. Yeah, I don't know if that's quite good enough for me. Let's just play a Mardu Scout. Let's just cast it. I feel like I can do a little better. I can set up a turn where my Flame Rush Rider is not going to die, either because Lotus Path Djinn attacks or because I get to Aerostorm something, then untap and play it. I don't know. We'll see what we can do here, but feels like I can do better. All right. Well, I'm just going to take it here since it could easily be an Obzon Guide. In fact, that's what it looks like. Lotus Path Djinn and Obzon Guide fighting side by side as usual. Now what's the play? I could dash out Flame Rush Rider that hits my opponent for 10 and gets me a token. I can Aerostorm away the Obzon Guide. Kind of liking Aerostorming the Obzon Guide. I can also just cast Flame Rush, but that doesn't seem great to me. Alright, let's just Aerostorm Obzon Guide attack for 5 here. I could do it pre-combat, post-combat, it doesn't really matter. Alright, bash. These graveyards here. Alright. I don't like the whole graveyard vertical zone, but I do like that you can drag them out there. And again, if my opponent ever gets into a spot where they can't profitably block Flame Rush Rider, then I'll be pretty happy to dash it out there. Like if they just play a morph for something. Grim Harrow Specs. Obzon Beastmaster. Interesting. So I could again dash out Flame Rush Rider, and then it gets blocked by Grim Harrow Specs. That's not the worst. Could also just barrage my opponent to kill the Beastmaster and then attack for some damage. Actually, you know what? I think I may. No. Then my opponent draws a card here. That's kind of lame. If I dash out Flame Rush, my opponent's drawing a card anyway, though. I could attack. If my opponent blocks Mardu Scout with Beastmaster, then I could just cast Flame Rush Rider. And if they don't block, I can cast Hordling Outburst plus Barrage of Boulders. I think I like that. No matter what, my opponent's drawing an extra card here, which is unfortunate, but... yeah, alright. Given that, I think I'd rather just cast Flame Rush. Then play a Tranquil Cove. Though, you know, I don't know. Maybe it would have been better just to cast Whirling Outburst and pass. This does give my opponent a turn to potentially deal with Flame Rush Rider. But it also ends up being much better if I draw something I can cast, because I end up with actual more cards on the board. Let's see what this is. If this is like a throttle on Flame Rush Rider, then I wasn't going to be in great shape regardless. Looks like an Obzon Charm to me, which I don't love the idea of a Grim Contest. Yeah. Getting kind of destroyed by my opponent's Lotus Path Djinn in this particular instance. I'm going to 7 here. And hopefully my opponent plays a 1 toughness creature, but they're probably going to play a morph. And I'm going to draw a Seeker of the Way. Alright, well, think of attacking and playing a Seeker of the Way plus a Hordling Outburst here. Trading with the Grim Horror Specs out, that makes sense. Alright, play Seeker, play Outburst, and do I need to play a land here? I guess given that I have Tormenting Voice, I probably shouldn't. Right. Yeah, the life gained off my opponent's odds on guide is making things a little more difficult here. I wonder if it would have turned out... You know, it might have turned out a lot better just to cast Hordling Outburst Barrage the turn I cast Flame Rush, because then my opponent would have drawn a few less cards and then potentially used Grim Contest to not kill Flame Rush. Then, of course, if I dashed out Flame Rush Rider, there's a decent chance it does get Grim Contested there, which still doesn't look good for me. Alright, well, pretty sure I'm casting Barrage here. Because that also gains me some life off Seeker of the Way, unless my opponent's got an answer. Utter End. Yeah, that's not going to be great for me. Well, it still draws a card, and I guess I've got to leave some... Four? Alright, let's attack for three, leave two goblins back to block Grim Horror Specs. Still not playing my land because of Tormenting Voice. Passing the turn, opponent's on millions and millions of cards. Opponent's deck looks pretty good, at least all the cards they've played are good. Saga Archer is just a fine morph. Still don't really know why there's a Lotus Pathogen hanging out there, but I'm sure it will become clear as we play this match. But I mean, who knows, if my opponent's got four or five non-basics, this is a fine card. It is a very good card, so I don't necessarily have a problem with it. I have a problem with the fact that it's, you know, crushing me, but it's an entirely different thing. Alright, what do we got here? I wonder if I should have just dashed out Flame Rush Rider on turn 4, traded it for Lotus Pathogen. Yeah, that doesn't seem like it would have... Silumgar? Oh, man. Well, Silumgar's just unbeatable. I mean, I was dead this game anyway to the Lotus Pathogen, but I don't like my chances if there's a Silumgar floating around, drifting around even. All right. I think I'm good here.